Hello, everyone. It's Chris Jones of lifewriting.com here with another segment of the lifewriting.com spotlights. With me on this segment is Miss Brianna Roberson.
Thank you so much for inviting me.
SoulBean CoffeeHouse.
Oh, yeah.
In little old Waynesboro, Georgia, our hometown, by the way. Tell me, how did it come about?
Yeah, so one, it started with a need for staying awake. So I started drinking coffee when I was in college. And I was more so, I wasn't into the kind of the lattes. I just needed Folgers to get me through every night. Because, I mean, you're studying all night. And then, of course, I had a party. So there's a little bit of that. But then once I got a job, graduated from college, got a job, moved to the Midwest, I kind of stepped up a little bit. And I really fell in love with kind of your specialty coffees. And I remember, so moved there, fell in love with coffee shops. And then my mom and my sister came back to visit me one time. And I remember when we were sitting in a coffee shop and I said, I really want to open a coffee shop. Like this is such like heaven to me right now. I feel whole just being here. I think this is something I should do in the coming years. And my younger sister, who was working at Starbucks, she's going to kill me for saying this, but she was working at Starbucks at the time. And she said, well, making coffee isn't as easy as it looks. And I was like, it can't be that hard. Like, it's just coffee. And I ate my words. Making coffee is very hard. A lot that goes to it. So that's where I found my love for coffee. And then as I was looking at different places, you know, I obviously thought of the Midwest, since it's so popular there, start one there. Okay. But I was thinking, I was like, my hometown doesn't have one. We don't have this experience. And this is something I would love when I was in high school. Right. So I came back home and opened up the coffee house, and it's been going pretty great.
Yeah. So, like you said, something you would love to have had when you were in high school. So speaking of high schoolers and, you know, your typical customers, you know, or what have you, do you have a lot of high schoolers and, you know, that age group coming by?
My typical customers are always going to be office workers. So people who are kind of headed off, they want a specialty coffee. So that's number one in the morning time, but definitely in the afternoon. We have we don't have a college per se here, but we do have a technical college. We don't have a university, I should say. So we have a technical college, and there are a lot of students who are in joint enrollment in that technical college. And so they get out of high school a half a day, and they normally go to the technical college. But instead of studying there, they really like to come here and study off campus a little bit. And that gives them time because they're mixed with high schoolers and with adults who are also going to that college. Meet here and they can study, they can form groups, kind of like have that dialogue outside of just being right there in the classrooms. And so that's where I really see that young, fresh, I want to go to college and I can't wait to have this experience every day.
Absolutely.
Yep.
Okay. No, that's cool. So on the kind of on the opposite end of the spectrum, you know, the older crowd, right? Folks like me.
Yeah. So we have a few events. I'm thinking of the events that's coming up. It's not just kind of catered toward a specific group, but maybe the need for the area. So at one point in time, I was struggling with my business finances with business. I'm an accountant by trade, but I hate taxes. So I was struggling kind of finding the different tax, the ways to minimize my taxes for my business. So I said, hey, this is the perfect opportunity to have an event series dedicated towards finances for business owners. So we had a series in April, and that April is also Financial Literacy Month, catered toward taxes, catered toward real estate, and minimizing your taxes and credit repair and all of that. So that was geared more towards the adults. But we have an event coming up later in August that is geared toward little kids, and it's going to be a princess tea party. We have a host and a variety, and we kind of geared Valentine's Day. We geared up a coffee tasting for couples,
okay,
and likes. So we have a variety of events.
So I'm going to put you on the spot, right? So I heard princes, nothing for the prince you know, the prince of Waynesboro and Burke County, you know, they need a lot of coffee activity related as yeah. well. What's the deal with that?
Yeah, so the princess one is a little bit more popular right now. We do have a superheroes theme one coming up in July.
There we go. Okay.
Yeah, and I'm not gonna reveal who the superhero is gonna be, but it's gonna be somebody that everyone likes.
Okay. Awesome. You know, look, I got a little almost 4-year old, so I had to kind of throw him into the hat of things, right? Just in case he's with me, you know, the next time I visit Waynesboro. And oh, by the way, I've shared this with you a couple times. Yeah. Whenever I visit my native home, Waynesboro specifically, I will make it my business to be by. I'm telling you that Snickers, maybe I need to scale the menu to really see if I like something else, but I'm one of those, I'm a loyal customer. If I see something I like, if I taste something that I really like, it's my go-to. So
I'm not going to lie. There is 2 drinks that I drink on my menu every day. That's it. I do not drink. There's probably about 500 combinations here. I only drink 2. So.
Really?
I know what I like.
So, Brianna, I want to do something, right? I want to, speaking of the menu and such, I want to bring up, obviously the first thing I wanted to show everyone, those who have yet to see it, read it, or what have you, I wrote a feature story on you sometime last month, I believe it was. And, folks were checking it out. They were reading and finding out all of those, they were finding out more about Brianna, the lady behind the brand, right? And, I've always felt, that's a very important aspect of business, especially when you're dealing with, when you're front-facing customers, they should know who they're talking with, who they're dealing with, who's making their coffee, who's around their coffee, sandwiches, whatever the case may be. So, folks read this article and they found out so many things about you. We'll touch on a few of them later, but what I wanted to go to is that that menu that you just touched on, right?
Yeah.
So, and this is probably 2 more for my edification because I just told on myself. I have 1 go-to. I've yet to scale the entire menu. So having said that, what is another popular item? And we can kind of scale down the list as we go.
Right. Yeah. First, I want to mention that menu is more of at the very top is a simplified menu, because something that when I was being introduced to the specialty coffees, I was always afraid of, well, what do I want? And even now, knowing a little bit more about coffees, I still walk into, dare to say the name, Starbucks, and they have 3 things on the menu. And I'm like, well, I don't know. Like, can you give me a couple of combinations to choose for me? So that's just a simplified menu. So that way you can just say, hey, I want a macchiato today. Add in a few, just add in a syrup that I love. But if you really want to go into, come into the coffee house every day, if you scroll down to the bottom, then you can see our full menu. And that's also where you can order online. And it'll have like the different specials that we may have. So yeah, you can keep scrolling to the online ordering. And then if you click on drinks, let's see what's happening here. All right, and let's try latte specials.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and that will give you all of the different types of special combinations of drinks that we put together. So roasted nut latte. So like I said, I like 2 lattes. Roasted nut is 1. The second one is caramel macchiato.
Nice.
And so that way it kind of puts that pressure off of the customer from always having to come in here and make up their own combination. They can come in and say, I want peanut butter today. Great. We got a roasted nut latte. I really like butterscotch. Great. You can order the butterscotch cookie latte.
Nice. And there's my Snickers.
Yes. The most popular.
Nice.
And I was not, honestly, the Snickers was supposed to be a 1 month special, but it really, I mean, it created marketing for me, honestly. No. It really got my foot started and what everybody wanted to come in here and purchase. So,
the small bites, you know, I've yet to eat anything there. What is a popular item of choice for folks?
So there are a lot of people, I would say, in Waynesboro because it never had a coffee house. So they want to come in here and they just want to grab kind of like food for lunch. And that turkey and ham BLT is by far my most popular menu item. Some days I sell more of that than I do of coffee. Exactly. And okay. I was actually a little afraid when it came to the paninis when I was being introduced to them. So when I first opened, for that first month, I did not sell any paninis because this is my first business venture. I wasn't sure how it would work with labor, with us learning coffee. Right. So when I opened up the paninis and people started eating, I also call it the club sandwich. When people started eating that club sandwich, that grew in immense popularity. And now I have nonstop catering orders just for that club sandwich. So
wow,
far the most popular sandwich I have on the menu.
So let's expand from there, the catering aspect of it. So how has that, the world of catering been when it comes to just everything you have to offer?
Is that actually for our coffee house? It really helped me during the pandemic because there were a lot of actual funerals that were held outside. And so when you think of a funeral at the repast, you have your chicken, your collard greens, your cornbread, and people may like kind of go online. Well, nobody could touch anything during the pandemic. So people really wanted just a grab and go bag. And so we cater, I mean, at one point in time, there was about, I think, 15 funerals in 1 week. And we got the catering order for all of those just so they can just grab a bag and go. And we had our club sandwich in there, give them a chips muffin and a bottle of water. And it was great. And it took off. And once one person found about that, then people started having meetings and they would order coffee in the club sandwich or they'll order coffee in a breakfast panini. And yeah, that really, and I learned the key to business is not only the inside foot traffic, but also how can you meet the customers where they're at? And catering really do help me get to that point.
Yeah, having the mindset and the wherewithal to see it through. And of course, you being an accountant, you know, by trade, having that accounting background really helps, you know, with kind of putting, certain methodologies together, right?
Yeah.
The types of thinking that, you know, not a lot of business owners are equipped with, that's the type of stuff they outsource, right? But again, you having, you know, the mind, the way your mind is wired, I should say, that really, really helps from an entrepreneurial standpoint.
Yeah, and I get a lot of feedback. I only see numbers in here. Everybody else is making coffee. I'm looking at numbers.
But even my last conversations with you, you were talking numbers then. And you were relating everything I ask you to numbers. You know, you were quantifying everything. And I'm like, okay, I have to remember who I'm talking to, right? but again, That's a positive thing, especially from an entrepreneurial standpoint. Especially a budding entrepreneur, you know, because you gotta test things, you gotta sample things. So that didn't work. Maybe I need to tweak this process, right? Or processes or whatever the case may be. So that, look, to know that something like this is in Waynesboro, Georgia, and flourishing, to say the least. And you know, I've commented several times about the name itself. Mm-hmm. SoulBean. May I ask what was behind that?
My experience with coffee shops where, I mean, I would spend hours, especially on Saturdays, I would go to a coffee shop and spend all day there. But I never heard Solange playing. I never heard Erykah Badu, or I never even heard any Selena playing. So I wanted to create an atmosphere that really reflected who I am, and it may be a gap in the coffee industry that was not targeted before. So soul, having more of R&B artists here, having soulful paintings and sculptures and artists. If you come inside the shop, you see this one abstract painting that's beautiful and definitely soulful. You definitely see all of those elements of soul and music and coffee within that one painting. And it was created by a great artist, and I'm gonna give him a shout out, Dontenaris Kelly, because he's an amazing young artist right here in our community. But that is exactly where the name came from, and I'm kind of glad that a lot of people are resonating with that.
Nice, I like it. You know, see, that there's a story behind everything, and I've been in and around the business community of things for quite some time. And names just, they've always resonated with me, kind of to your statement you just made. And I was just eager to find out. I'm like, I gotta find out what's behind that name, because in the feature story about you, I never touched on any of that. If you had your way, you know, you mentioned the princess a while ago, right? If you could wave your wand, right? Where would you like to see SoulBean CoffeeHouse in the next, say, 10 years?
Oh man, I love this experience. I definitely want to expand, go to a couple more cities, maybe have this in areas that are a little bit less diverse, because okay. That's one of the things that I kind of suffered with when I lived in Iowa. Iowa was a great city. I loved living there. But it definitely was, it's not as diverse as Georgia. Right. And so I always kind of craved one spot that I could really just feel home. So if I could have a little bit less diverse cities, have it near some colleges, because the college atmosphere is really where you can get the most out of a coffee house. So definitely not just this location, but multiple locations, but also continue to learn what my customers want. Like I said, this is my first business venture. So offering more sandwiches or food items, that's what I'm learning here. Coffee is great, but they also want to have a couple more food items on the menu, just so they can switch it up every day, because I have some really loyal customers. They've been here from day one, and they're like, all right, four sandwiches awesome. Is just not enough.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Okay. Good. I have spoken offline several times, and, you know, thank you for being receptive. You know, you said this is your first business, right? So all of the resources, as I shared with you before, that you can amass and be able to reach out and touch whenever you need them, you know, him or her, I mean, do it. And you've clearly shown that you're not above anything. That's something I saw in you the first time I met you. And I was like, you know what? Yeah. She is going to be all right. And at the same time, she has something in her, and I think I shared this with you and your mom for that matter. She has something in her that a lot of people her age may not have, but that you can offer some nuggets to and for. In saying that, and we'll get ready to close this out, what words of wisdom would you tell, what you share with a budding entrepreneur, not say in the coffee world of things, but in any business venture, what nugget or two would you share with him or her?
Oh man, I can't think of any other better slogan than Nike's. Just do it. Just wow. Like, yeah. Figure it out later on. I tell everybody, I quit my job during the pandemic. It may seem like it's going to be tough. It's going to be hard. And I'm not saying that it's not. It's definitely the days that are not easy, that I'm laying in bed and I'm crying my eyes out. But then there are other days that I just can't stop laughing and sharing my smile with others. So yeah, go for it. If it's a dream that you have, it's better to go for that dream and even honestly fail at it and then start it over again, then wait until you're 40 and 50 years old and wish that you would have done it. So
yeah, be that shoulda, woulda, coulda person.
Yeah.
No, that's awesome. And I'm that resonated with me as well. And just so true words. And look, go for it, just do it, like you said, you know, just Nike the doggone thing. And if you fail once, you know, fail again until you ultimately have your breakthrough and be having that success story and sharing it, you know, with other folks, paying it back or forward, if you will. So that's awesome stuff, and congratulations again.
Thank you, mentor.
Look, I can hardly wait to get there again. I know what I'm gonna have my Snickers latte, but I promise to try something else as well. I'll take another look at the menu. Folks, I want to tell everyone to read the feature story. There's so much information in there. Just giving them a background again, like on the woman behind the brand, right? Who's behind SoulBean? Thank you again for even allowing me to write that up. I had a lot of fun writing it up. I'll leave it at that. Yeah.
So well, thank you so much, Chris.
Okay, so everyone, again, that was Brianna Roberson. She's doing a lot of things in that community. As you can see, very vibrant, smart, intelligent, and very personable. You know, you need a lot of that in the world of entrepreneurship. So thanks again for watching. And as always, take care out there and tune in again at liferighting.com, where writing speaks.